Hello students, myself Hardik Patel from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. In the last session, we have seen the curl and divergence. In today's session, we are going to see the scalar potential function of a conservative field. Okay? Now, first of all, what is the scalar potential function of a conservative field? If you have F bar is equal to grade 5, okay, then the curl of F bar is going to be a zero. Okay, such vector field F bar is said to be a conservative field, and the function, scalar function phi, whose gradient is F bar, that scalar function phi is said to be a potential function. Okay, that means if you have given directly F bar whose curl is zero, then there exists some scalar function phi whose gradient is going to be a F1. Done? Okay. Now, first show that F bar is equal to 2xyzi plus x square z plus 2y into j plus x square y into k is conservative. Find its scalar potential function phi. Okay? So, if you are starting with the solution, then first one, we have F bar is equal to 2xyzi plus x square z plus 2y into j plus x square yk. Okay. So, first we have to show it is conservative. So, we are starting with a curl of F bar. That is I, j, k, del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, 2x, y, z, x square z plus 2y, and x square y. Okay? So, I into derivative of this term with respect to y, that will be a x square, minus derivative of this term with respect to z, that will be again x square, minus j into derivative of this term with respect to x, that is 2xy, minus derivative of this term with respect to z, that is also 2xy, plus k into derivative of this term with respect to x, that is 2xz, minus derivative of this term with respect to z, sorry, with respect to y, that will be again 2xz. So you have 0i plus minus 0j plus 0k. Now minus or plus 0 are same, so you have a 0 vector. And therefore, the field F bar is conservative field. Okay? This is the first thing. Secondly, you have to find the scalar potential function. So, what we are going to do, we are going to continue with a let F bar is equal to grade 5. Correct? So, what we will have is F bar is our 2xyzi plus x square z plus 2y into j plus x square y into k is equal to del phi by del x into I, del phi by del y into j, and del phi by del z into k by definition of gradient. Now comparing components, so comparing both sides, and that will give you del phi by del x is equal to 2xyz, del phi by del y is equal to x square z plus 2y and del phi by del z is equal to x square y. Now basically we have to integrate these terms with respect to x, y and z. So integrating with respect to x partially, and that will give you phi is equal to, you are integrating with respect to x. So x as the integration x square by 2, y and z are treated as a constant because we are taking a partial integration. So it will be a x square y z plus some function of y and z, because you are integrating with respect to x. Okay, same manner integrating with respect to y partially, and that will give you phi is equal to, you are integrating this term with respect to y, so it will be a x square yz plus y square plus, this is some function of yz, now you have some function of xz because you are integrating with respect to y. Same manner integrate with respect to z partially, and that will give you phi is equal to x square yz plus some function of x, y. Okay. So now using these three, we are going to write down the function phi. How to write it? You have to write down one term once only. No repetition is required. So first term we have x square yz plus integrating constant, we are not writing it here. Now x square yz is already here, plus we have second term is y square. This is integrating constant, x square yz is already here, this is integrating constant. So instead of all this integrating constant, plus we are going to put some constant c. So using this, we have a scalar potential function phi is equal to x square yz plus y square plus. Okay. Same manner, second example we have f bar is conservative and find the scalar potential function. Okay. So the same thing we have to repeat. We are going to find curl first. Now I am directly starting with a curl of f bar is I, j and k, del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, e raised to x cos y. Here we have xz minus e raised to x sin y and xy plus z. Okay. Now, I into derivative with respect to y, that means x, minus derivative with respect to z, that is x, minus j into derivative of this term with respect to x, minus derivative of this term with respect to z, plus k into derivative of this term with respect to x, that is z, minus e raised to x sin y, minus derivative of this term with respect to y. So e raised to x as a derivative, sorry, cos y as a derivative minus sin. So minus minus plus e raised to x sin y, and yz as a derivative z, so minus z, and that will give you 0i plus 0j plus 0k. So you have a zero vector, and that implies f bar is conservative. Now it is conservative. So what we are going to do, we are going to assume let f bar is equal to grad phi, and that implies e raised to x cos y plus y z into I plus x z minus e raised to x sin y into J plus XY plus Z into K is equal to del phi by del X into I plus del phi by del Y into J plus del phi by del Z into K. Now comparing components both sides. That will give you del phi by del X is equal to e raised to X cos Y plus Y Z. Same manner del phi by del Y is X Z minus e raised to X sin Y. And del phi upon del Z, that will be a X Y plus Z. Now, you have to find out phi, so we are going to integrate this and this with respect to x, y and z partially. So integrating with respect to x partially, and that will give you phi is equal to integration with respect to x. So e raised to x is the integration e raised to x cos y as it is, and integration of y z, that will be a x y z plus what I have told you, some function of y z. Same with the second one, integrating with respect to y partially, and that implies what we have x z as integration x y z, e raised to x constant. Sine has an integration minus cos, so minus minus plus cos plus some function of xz. Same in the last term, integrating with respect to z partially, and that will give you phi is equal to integration with respect to z, so xyz plus z square by 2 plus some function of xy. Okay? Now using these three, we are going to write the function. So first you have e raised to x cos y plus x, y, z. Then x, y, z is already here, e raised to x cos y is already here. Then here we have x, y, z. X, y, z is already here. So only term we have to write down is z squared by 2. And plus we are writing the integrating constant C from 3 or 4. So this one is our required scalar potential function phi. Okay? So this is the method to obtain the scalar potential function. And if your field is conservative, then in that case, you can always find out the scalar potential phi. Same manner, the third example we have directly written, find the scalar potential phi. Correct? So here no need, if you have given that find the scalar potential phi, that means you have to prove that curl of F bar is 0. So we are starting with curl of F bar, that is I, J, K, del by del X, del by del Y, del by del z, multiply this inside, that is e raised to y plus 2z, x into e raised to y plus 2z, and 2x into e raised to y plus 2z. So if you are taking derivative directly, derivative with respect to y, so 2x into e raised to y plus 2z as it is, minus derivative with respect to z, so x e raised to y plus 2z, e raised to as a derivative e raised to, and y plus 2z as a derivative 2 because you are differentiating with respect to z, minus j into derivative of this term with respect to x, that means 2 e raised to y plus 2z, minus derivative of this term with respect to z, so e raised to y plus 2z into 2, plus k into If you are differentiating this term with respect to x, then e raised to y plus 2z as it is minus derivative with respect to y, that is e raised to y plus 2z. And that will give you 0i plus 0j plus 0k. And that implies f bar is so conservative. Now, we are going to find the scalar potential. So I am directly now writing that f bar is equal to grade phi, and that will give you del phi by del x is equal to e raised to y plus 2z del phi by del y, that is x into e raised to y plus 2z, and del phi by del z is 2x into e raised to y plus 2z. And if you are integrating with respect to x partially, and that will give you phi is equal to, you are integrating with respect to x, so this is constant, so you have integration x into e raised to y plus 2z plus some function of yz. Same manner, you are integrating with respect to y partially, that will give you phi. If you are integrating with respect to y, then x is constant, e raised to as an integration e raised to y plus 2z plus some function of x, y. And same manner, integrating with respect to z partially, that will give you phi is equal to 2x e raised to y plus 2z upon 2, because you are integrating with respect to z, plus some function of x, y. So here 2 will be cancelled out. And if you are writing the function phi, then you have only one term, x into e raised to y plus 2z plus integrating constant c. Okay. So these are the topics which we have covered in today's session. If you have any doubt or any query regarding this topic, then please feel free to contact me. Thank you so much.